राइट दिस डीकंपोजिशन रिएक्शन this decomposition reaction is used for preparing oxygen gas in the laboratory. Is it okay, Amma? Most important thing.
Decomposition reaction.
Oxygen gas in the laboratory. Laboratory. Okay, Dina. Okay, Ra. Dilipan.
Sir, yes, sir.
Sir, decomposition reaction after that.
Ore, what, man? Is used for preparing. Don't write in rough notes. Write in classwork itself. Again, don't waste time. This is the example number 2. Any doubt?
No, sir.
Now they will ask you a question. Give the example of preparation of oxygen in laboratory. Then what you will do?
Potassium chloride.
Next one. Example 3. This is also one of the most important reaction, Ra. Everybody remember that. When ferrous sulfate is heated strongly, it decomposes to form ferric oxide, or else you can write ferric oxide, comma, sulfur trioxide and sulfur trioxide. Now tell me the chemical equation, all of you. Let me see who will say. Chemical equation.
Yes. FeSO4.
Solid state. It will start heating. Heat. And here what will come? Decomposition. Understanding?
Ferric oxide.
Decomposition. What will come? Ferric oxide means
ferric oxide.
F2O3. Present also in solid state. Understanding? Ferric oxide. Remember, FeRRIC. Ferric oxide. Understanding? That first one is ferrous oxide. FeO, ferrous oxide. Be very careful. This is ferric oxide.
Okay.
This one is ferrous oxide. FeO is ferrous oxide. So, which will form along with that? Sulfur dioxide. What is the state? Sulfur dioxide.
Yes. Yes.
Gas.
Gas.
Sulfur dioxide also.
Gaseous state only.
But in this reaction, the most important thing is, remember, ferrous sulfate. Change in color is also example of this one. This one we can write is under change in color also. So ferrous sulfate color is always green color. What is the color of this one?
Green color.
All of you remember. Green color. Ma, this is the most important reaction. That is why you keep ending also. Most important reaction. Green color. Understand? And if you start heating strongly, then what will happen? Ferric oxide. The color of
ferric oxide.
Brown color. What is this color?
Brown color.
So, can you able to remember this?
Yes, sir.
Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yeah.
And ferrous sulfate also we can call it as iron 2 sulfate. That is also non-important. Iron R we can call it as iron 2 sulfate, Roman number. All of you keep it. Iron 2 sulfate and as well as ferric oxide. Understanding? Also we can call it as, understanding? Iron 3 oxide. Iron 3, Roman number 3, oxide, note it down. These all the things you people don't know. That is what I am saying. Are you people understanding, Ra?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Ferric 2 oxide or iron 2 oxide. Here, iron 3 oxide or also ferric oxide.
Brown color.
Can you able to remember?
Yes, yes, sir.
Now see, single substance giving how many products here?
Three products. Sir.
Reaction, remember few important points you should note down. So all of you keep writing note and you remember. Note and note it down. First listen, later you note it down your own. Understand? Because your mind should be working properly. That is what I want. I won't say, I will explain. You note it down your own. So see, in this reaction, the green color of ferrous sulfate changes into brown color. Brown color of what? Brown color of what?
Ferric oxide.
Changing. Understanding. Changes into brown due to the formation of ferric oxide. And in this reaction, if you'll observe, the smell of burning sulfur is obtained. Means like a rotenix. The smell of burning sulfur is obtained. Why? Because due to the formation of what? Burning of sulfur.
Sulfur dioxide and sulfur trioxide.
We'll get a smell of, understanding, smell of burning sulfur. Because why? Burning sulfur. Why?
Sulfur dioxide is obtained due to sulfur dioxide and sulfur trioxide.
Remember, not the because of sulfur trioxide. Sulfur trioxide is having no smell. Only because here the smell of burning sulfur is obtained due to the only formation of sulfur dioxide gas. Sulfur trioxide is forming, but because of sulfur dioxide only we'll get the rotenix smell, means burning of sulfur smell. Yes, so in this reaction, one substance is splitting up into how many substances?
Three substances.
So this is a decomposition reaction. But you remember, this is also what we can call heat reaction. So that another name for this one, what? Heat reactions also called
thermal decomposition.
Thermal decomposition.
Thermal decomposition reaction. Yes, super, really. So now, here you remember, next note point, very, very important. As we know that ferrous sulfate also called as iron 2 sulfate, ferric oxide also called as iron 3 oxide.
Iron 3 oxide.
Yes, when you take this ferrous sulfate crystals, which are available in our science laboratory, which are available in our laboratory. Remember, why they are green in color means they contains the water molecules also. Water means it is absorbed state, not separately. So whatever the ferrous sulfate, understanding, crystals which are available in our science laboratory, they are actually ferrous sulfate heptahydrate. What is the meaning of hepta?
Hepta.
Five, sir.
Hepta means, five means penta, hexa means six, seven means hepta. What, man? Mono, di, tri, tetra, penta, hepta, hexa, hepta, octa, nano, deca. So hepta means what?
Seven.
So actually, whatever the crystals which we have, ferrous sulfate crystals in our laboratory, it is actually a hydrated salt. Remember, this is a hydrated salt, means it is having a water molecules also. So, means it contains FeSO4 dot 7H2O. It contains seven molecules of water also. Understanding? So, these seven molecules of water of crystallization, these seven molecules of water only is called as water of crystallization. They contain seven molecules
water
of understanding seven molecules of water of crystallization. Water of crystallization. Very important thing. Water of crystallization. So the salt is called as hydrated salt. What we used to call it, Amma?
Hydrated salt.
So now, because of this water only, this color is what? Which color?
Green color.
You remember. Understanding? So, if we'll start heating this, so before forming the ferric oxide, sulfur dioxide, and sulfur dioxide, this water molecules first will evaporate. Understanding? So, they first lose the seven molecules of water of crystallization. Should not say the word called as seven molecules of water. What we should use? What we have to use?
Seven molecules of water of crystallization.
If we'll remove the water, then that is known as anhydrous ferrous sulfate. What is to call? Before containing water,
anhydrous ferrous sulfate.
So water is removed. What is the formula?
FeSO4.
That's all. Understanding? So this FeSO4 only gives what?
Ferric oxide plus
sulfur dioxide.
Yes, sir.
But you remember,
if water is removed, the color also will change.
7H2O. You may ask the question, why you are not writing, sir, 7H2O means? Understanding? We are not written ferrous sulfate crystals without water here. Why we have written means? Just to keep the equation very simple. Written like this. But actually, we should represent what? 7H2O also. Correct or not, Amma?
Sir, I have a doubt. Sir, you said that ferrous, due to that seven molecules of H2 only, ferrous sulfate have the green color, sir.
Green color.
If that water molecules are removed, then how sir the same color will make?
Ask that doubt. Very good. So, which will turns into understanding. Once if it is having water molecules, it is a green color. Once this water will be evaporated, immediately it will turns into anhydrous ferrous sulfate. The color is white color. What we should call, Amma?
White colors.
Remember that. Is it okay, Ra?
Hydrated ferrous
sulfate color is green. Anhydrated ferrous sulfate color is what?
White color.
White. Till present tenth also, so many don't know the colors differences. Even toppers, if you take, they also don't know. Understanding? That is what I'm saying. Note you keep, and is all the points should come under note. So you need to say, or you people can write your own.
Sir, say the points alone, sir.
You should not say seven water molecules. You should not. You have to say what? What is it?
Seven molecules of crystallization.
Seven molecules of water crystals.
Always remember, science means language is most important. Language means not English language, the Tamil language. Science language. Language of science is most important here. Right now, points. Hydrated ferrous sulfate contains seven molecules of water of crystallization.
Water of crystallization.
So these crystals are green in color. Have you written this equation?
Yes, sir.
All of you?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Seven crystals are seven what? It is green in color. Teratama.
So these crystals are green in color. Yes, sir.
Yeah, green in color. This is known as hydrated ferrous sulfate. This is known as hydrated salt. You can write hydrated ferrous sulfate. Hydrated ferrous sulfate. Hydrated ferrous sulfate, you can write as a hydrated salt. Bracket. Hydrated salt. Formula. Fe2SO4.7H2O. 7H2O means what we should call, Ra?
Seven molecules of water of
ferrous sulfate. Heptahydrate. What is to call?
Heptahydrate.
That is the first point. Next. If we heat hydrated ferrous sulfate. If we heat hydrated ferrous sulfate. First, what it will lose, Ra? What it will lose first?
Water.
First. Water. Yeah. First. Yes. First. If we heat hydrated ferrous sulfate, first lose 7 molecules of water of crystallization. First lose 7 molecules of water of crystallization. 7 molecules of water of crystallization, and it will form what immediately? Crystallization to form? To form which one? Hydrated or unhydrated? To form?
Unhydrated, sir.
To form anhydrous ferrous sulfate. To form anhydrous ferrous sulfate. Anhydrous ferrous sulfate. What is the formula?
FeSO4.
Which is white in color.
Sir, say that after, if we heat hydrated ferrous sulfate.
Anhydrous ferrous sulfate. Anhydrous ferrous sulfate, FeSO4 in bracket, which is white in color.
After it loses
7 molecules. Molecules of water of crystallization. 7 molecules of water of crystallization to form anhydrous ferrous sulfate, which is white in color. Is it clear or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now, after this, what will happen? It will turn into what? Normal, as usual equation. This white, which one turns into anhydrous oxide. Fe2O3+, sulfur dioxide + sulfur trioxide. Is it correct or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, but balancing equation is most important. Which will come under what? This is solid, and this is gas, and this is gas. But here you have to take FeSO4. What is that? 2FeSO4. Balancing is most important. 2FeSO4. Is it okay, da?
Yes, sir.
2FeSO4. Balancing equation is most important. So, till here I am going to stop the today's class. Then tomorrow we'll meet. Thank you all.